Imagine you want to use a software, but you have difficulty using it in an effective way. Why? Because you don't have much knowledge about the functions of that software. You want somebody to help you. What about using AI to help you, to walk you through step by step in order to be able to use the software in an efficient way? What you can see here is Atlas.ti is a qualitative software, and this one is a web version of Atlas.ti. Imagine you are new to this software and you want somebody to help you. What about trying using AI? When you go to Google AI Studio, so this is the web address here. When you go to Google AI Studio, there's a function there that can help you to use a new software that you are not familiar with, right? When you go there, this is what you see. But the place that you have to go is to click on Stream Real Time. So this function will help you to show your screen and ask the system some questions, and the system will be able to walk you through and help you to accomplish a goal or learn about a specific software. I want to also say that it's not perfect, but I think that as time goes on, it will be a very good tool to give you a tutorial, having a conversation with the system, and the system will be able to walk you through to be able to accomplish a goal. So let's try this one and see. So we have our data that we want to analyze, and we want the system to help us to analyze our data. We want to use Atlas.ti. So let me show you Atlas.ti here. We want the system to walk us through how to use Atlas.ti. So this is what we're going to do, right? First, you make sure that you click on share your screen. So because you have to share your screen to the system, then the system will be able to help you. So we click on share your screen and you choose the screen that you want to share.
Okay, the system will help you. Now, you need to click on share your screen. Then you have to move around and see which screen that you want to share. Let me see. Do you have a specific screen in mind you want to share?
Yes. So let me see. Okay. So I'm sharing my screen now.
Okay. You are sharing your screen now. Is there anything in particular you would like me to see or any actions I should observe?
So this is the Atlas.ti website, and I'm trying to analyze my qualitative data. And I want you to walk me through step by step how to use this software to analyze my data. What do you see here before we start?
Okay, I see the Atlas.ti website, and you are trying to analyze your qualitative data. You want me to walk you through step by step on how to use this software to analyze media. What I see here are your different projects listed, such as Project C, Project 4, and several burnout project files. Is this correct, and what should I do next?
What I want to do is to create a new project. So where should I click to create a new project?
Okay, you want to create a new project. In the upper right corner of the screen, there is a blue button labeled Add Project. You should click that to create a new project.
So I've clicked on that. I go to create project and I'm going to give it a name. So the project is about burnout among primary healthcare physicians. So I'm going to type burnout.
Okay, I see that you clicked on the Add Project button and then Create Project, and now the Create a New Project dialog box is open and you're about to type Burnout as the actual project name. Is that correct?
Yes. So as you can see here, I've typed Burnout Project A, right? Do I have to give a description or is optional?
Okay, I see you have typed Burnout Project A as the name of your new project. Now you're asking if you have to provide a description. The description box is optional. You don't have to enter anything there if you don't want to. Do you want to proceed without a description, or would you like me to help you add one?
I just want to proceed. I'm going to click on create new project.
Okay, you've decided to proceed without a description, and you're going to click on create new project. Is that correct?
Yes. So now, what should I do next? Do I have to upload my transcript?
Yes, that's right. Now that you have created the project, you need to upload your documents to start analyzing. You can do this by clicking the Add Document button. Okay. Do you want to proceed with that?
Yes. So click on Add Document. I'm going to look for my document. I have five transcripts from primary healthcare physicians. They talk about their burnout experience, the causes and the solutions of burnout. So I've selected that and then click on open. And now I think I have all of them here.
Okay, I see you clicked add document and then selected Word document. You chose to convert to plain text, and now you have imported five transcripts. Is there anything else I can assist you with at the moment, or are you ready to begin?
Yes, I want to begin analyzing my data. So what should I do next?
Okay, you have uploaded the five transcripts and are ready to begin analyzing your data. Now you need to choose a document to start with. Do you have a particular document you would like to begin with? Or should we just go through them in order?
I was thinking I want to use AI to help me to analyze the data. I think I heard that they have a function called intentional AI. And I've heard that I have to first select the transcript that I have to do. So I've selected them. And then I go here, there are tools here that I can select. So I'm going to choose AI coding. What do you think? So sometimes when you are using this software, AI, Google Studio, it cut off. So sometimes you have to go back again and then reconnect. So let's go back to the studio. So you see that it's saying that something went wrong. So if it happens, what you have to do is click on stream. I think maybe first click on AI Studio and then click on stream red time. And then go back to share your screen. So let me click here to share my screen.
Okay, I see your screen. It looks like you're on a website with a document manager. There is also a pop-up about an AI coding beta powered by OpenAI. Do you want me to describe anything else on the screen?
Yeah, I just want to give you a little background before we start. So I am using a software called Atlas.ti to analyze my qualitative data. I have uploaded all my transcripts. So as you can see here, I have five transcripts and I want to use the AI function to analyze my data. So I selected all the transcripts and then go to tools and click on tools and selected AI coding plus intention to help me for the system to automatically code my data for me. So that's where I've reached now. What should I do next?
Thanks for the background. It's very helpful. It sounds like you want to use the AI coding beta feature of the software to analyze your qualitative data and have already uploaded all your transcripts and selected the AI coding feature from the tools menu. Now you're wondering what to do next. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, to move forward with the AI coding beta, you should click the continue button on the pop-up. This will likely start the AI analysis process on your selected transcript.
So I click on continue, and then I click on proceed, and this is what I see. What should I do next?
Okay, it looks like the next step is to define your research goal. You should type your research goal into the provided text box. Once you do that, you should click the next button in the top right corner.
Okay, so I'm going to put the purpose of my study and also the research question that I want to address and then see what the system is going to help me with. So I've put that information, where should I click? Should I click next?
Yes, now that you've entered your research goal and questions, click the next button in the top right corner to proceed.
Okay, so I've clicked next and what do you see here? What do you think is going on?
I see a screen that says generating questions. It indicates that the system is using your research goal to generate related questions that will help with AI coding. There is a progress bar, and the message says this process could take up to 30 seconds.
Okay, so it looks like it has finished, right? So as you can see here, it has suggested the research questions for me. I think it's the same thing as the one that I uploaded, right? So I think I'm okay with these questions. Should I click next?
Yes, it looks like the system has generated category codes for your research questions and you are satisfied with the results. So you should click next to proceed to the next step.
Oh, okay. So what do you see here?
I see a screen that says AI coding in progress. It also says that depending on the workload, OpenAI may experience strong performance variations, often resulting in very long waiting times, and that Atlas.ti has no influence on this.
Okay, so now what do you see? I think the results has come. Can you explain what you see on the screen?
Okay, I see that the AI coding process is complete. On the left side of the screen, there is a section labeled 54 suggested codes with a variety of codes, including administrative tasks, building trust, career level, clinical tasks, and more. Each code has a counter next to it, showing how often it was found in the data. On the right side of the screen, there's a section labeled 69 quotations, showing quotes extracted from your documents. Each quotation has a category assigned to it. Finally, at the very top right of the screen, there is an Apply AI Coding button.
Okay, so do you think that for the suggested AI code, I can take some out and also leave some? Do I have the option? So as I said, you know, this one is not a perfect tool. You see that it's breaks. So you have to restart again and continue the conversation. And whenever you restart in case it breaks, you have to give a little bit of background about what is going on so that the system will be able to provide you very useful steps, right? I click on Google AI Studio again, and I click on stream real time and go to share your screen. And now I'm going to share my screen.
Okay, I understand you're going to share your screen. I'll be ready when you do.
So as you can see from this screen, I'm using Atlas.ti to analyze my qualitative data. And I think the AI tool within Atlas.ti has suggested some codes for me. Do I have the option for me to take some of the codes out, or I cannot take any code out if I don't want them?
Okay, it looks like you're using Atlas.ti to analyze qualitative data, and the AI tool is suggesting codes. You're wondering if you have the option to remove some of the codes that were suggested, or if you're required to use all of them. It appears you can remove them by clicking on the small X next to each one. Is there anything else I can help with?
Can you hold on and let me take some of the things out, and I'll let you know what next. After that, what should I do next? Should I click on Apply AI Coding?
After you've made your adjustments to the suggested codes, you should click Apply AI Coding. This will finalize your choices and apply the codes to your data. Do you have any other questions?
Okay, so I've clicked on Apply AI Coding. So let me go to the code manager and see whether I have the codes there. So it looks like I have codes under causes of burnout. I have a lot of codes, and then I have some and reduction strategies, right? So these are the solutions of burnout, right? So my next step is to try to categorize the codes. What should I do in this software for me to able to categorize the code?
Okay, it looks like you've applied the AI coding and are now in the code manager. You want to know how to categorize the codes within this software. It appears that you can expand the categories by clicking on the hamburger button next to causes of burnout and reduction strategies in order to see the individual codes that exist under each category. Is this what you are referring to?
Yes. So I'm trying to select some of them if they are related, and then I will plan the categorization. But let me see. Let me try some things out and see whether I'll be able to categorize. So I have selected four codes now. Let me see whether when I click on this one, I just want to find out from you, what is the difference between merge codes and add to group?
Okay, you want to know the difference between merging codes and adding to a group. Merging codes combines several codes into one, while adding to a group simply places codes into a category without merging them. Would you like to explore these functions in more detail?
I think I want to explore the second function, which is I'm trying to group them, categorize the codes. So maybe I have to click on this one, right? And what should I do next? Should I select manage groups?
Yes. If you are trying to categorize the codes, clicking on add to group and then manage groups would be the next step to take. Do you want to continue with that process?
Yes. I click on that and I have to create a new group, right? So I will just say numerous. What do you see here? I have typed something here.
I see you have typed numerous working hours into the text box.
Okay.
Now you can either...
Should I click on a plus sign?
Yes. Clicking the plus sign will create the new group, numerous working hours.
And then I click on done, right?
Yes, that is correct. Oh, you should click on done to finalize the creation of the new group. Then you can add codes to that group.
Oh, okay. So if I want to add a code to a group, what should I do? Should I just select and then...
To add a...
And then go click on this dot and then add to group. And then I can select that group, right?
Okay, so to add the selected codes to the numerous working hours group, you should click on the three dots, then select add to group, and then select the newly created group, numerous working hours. Is there anything else I can help you with?
So this is what I have for you. As I said, it's not that perfect, but you know, it's helping you, especially if you are not used to using a specific software to walk you through, to have a conversation. And it's always good to have some ideas, especially about a software general information so that you can benefit more from the conversation with the AI too. If you have any question, please let me know. I'll be happy to address them for you. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'll be bringing you a lot of information that will help you to do your research. And then I also provide methodology consultation if you want us to meet one-on-one to talk about your study, how to collect data, how to analyze and present your finding using a software. Yes, we can talk about that. I've put my email address in the description section there, but my email address is info@drphilipedu.com. Thank you for your time.